श्रीमती रामानुजाय नमः। That the human race, they have witnessed by lot of various things that happened in their socio-economical, political, religious, physical, mental, intellectual and global issues. A very important phenomenon that governs everything in the world is consciousness emergence. Yesterday I explained about the situation analysis and progressive analysis as well as problematic studies that exist in human beings. And this type of consciousness that emerges only with either a few limited group of people or an organized structure within a limited time framework and a provincial framework. It is known as the rule of natural emergence, and it is the study of universal consciousness in which it says that whenever a problem occurs or whenever a situation rises, whenever there is a situation, somebody will have an initial or inceptive curiosity to understand the situation and to get it interpreted. When there is an imposed situation within a group of people, that type of dissatisfaction or advanced curiosity will tempt them to go for more advancement and progression. In spite of that satisfaction, still there will be a craving, which is known as persistent or continuous curiosity, which will attempt or make a person to be tempted to go for progression. Whenever in the course of progression, unavoidably progress, each and every step of progress is unavoidably coupled with their own challenges, risks, ill consequences, disabilities, dilutions, debilitations, attacks and various other unwanted things they used to couple with this type of progress. At this time, yesterday I explained how this problematic status is being pondered by human beings by their cognitive drilling, cognitive invasion, how it is put into action. So likewise, this type of consciences, this type of what we call it as also an emerging consensus. So this type of emergence that happens only in few people, it is because of the person's configurative identity and compatibility with that of the issue. Whenever there is a poverty, there are a lot of people suffering in poverty. Then lot of people, those who are rich, who has to think about poverty? Those who are poor, they have to think about poverty because that is their problem. Those who are rich and comfortable, they have to think about the poverty because they are having unlawful enjoyment, whereas the group of the society is put into turmoil. So all the poor people, those who are being pressurized by poverty, they don't think about that. Even if they think that is not a productive thought, that could be culminated into a processing directive goal of getting into implementary services. That is not so. Even rich people, how many people will think that? So sacrifice, mercy, or problem solutions, these type of intellectual as well as clemential exercises are not executed by all members of the family. So it is told in the Shastras that first of all it is known as apti, second it is known as yapti. What is apti? Whenever there is the problem of patriotic degradation, whenever there is the problem of conversion or invasion, whenever there is the problem for cultural pressurization or cultural infiltration that happens in the nation, whenever the cruel heads of issues like poverty, unemployment, drug addiction, youth initiative problems, then various other issues of the society pertaining to various other members, wherever there is a discrimination, wherever there is a person's deprival of proper social and economic status and right, it does not occur in all minds to think about, to plan and execute. Only in few people it comes. It is known as apti. So according to the spiritual wisdom, whenever a person is getting into problem, the God, that is the substratum of universal consciousness, he has created three things. One is vitarana, second is avatarana, third is avatarana. It is told that he discerns by himself and takes care of his issues. And that is something remote and it is purely philosophical and theological. Let us keep it there. The second thing is avatarana, he delegates greater people who are capacious enough to govern these issues and provide solutions. So these solution providers, social service engineers and troubleshooters of the social critical commands are being delegated by the God himself, that is avatarana. Third thing is vitarana. Whenever there is a problem in the society, God offers that type of emerging consciousness, that type of vigilance is offered to a particular group of people, which permeates within the group. After being consolidated, it permeates to the other members of the society by means of gradual grouping. Number one, it is grouped within the like-minded people who are very strong and determined, number one. Number two, these strong and determined people, they attract also people, those who are shuffling and capricious. Third thing, those who are sleeping, those who require more consciousness emergence by means of an external stimuli, those people come under the third line. Those who are dipped in ignorance and arrogance, those who are dipped in total antagonism, skepticism, and total disastrous separation from that of the social concern, these people are very much consulted and very much concerned in the last stage. So, committed people and those people who are easily transformable, those who are somnolent, non-vigilant or kinetic in status, and the other ill members of the society who are there soaked and toasted in deep sleep of unconscious about the social concern, unconscious about the social turmoil, unconscious about the evolution of a new social renaissance. So it is known as grouping. So God creates a consciousness among a limited number of people known as apti, and this limited number of people, by means of the radiation, tejas, by means of the erudition, jnana, by means of the compassion, daya, also by means of proper organizational methodology, now the science has given information technology for information security, information governance, information data mining, preservation, orderliness, and spreading to everybody, we have all provisions. Printing technology is there. So this type of oral propagation, this type of promulgation methodologies which are conventional have been replaced by very potential media tools. So this type of a grouply organized, systematic, spontaneous emergence of dynamic consciousness is distributed effectively to people of a recent lenience and proclivity towards the goal of the organization. It is known as apti and vyapti. And whatever he has told now, it is something very sensational. There are two types of things, that which is immediately required and short-term benefited or ephemeral. That which is maybe long-term or not directly connected, but that has a deeper impact to the society. Our connection with the milkman, grocery man, our connection with school fees and paying rent and electricity, phone bill, these things are immediate. We are directly connected. And everybody is more concerned about our direct issues. But in long run, the national security, political decency, democratic rights of the people, integrity among the community, these things are no doubt as emergent as the fire service, ambulance, police attention, etc. But those things, we consider that as they are not of so instantaneous and direct. Actually, there are two things. In social mentality of a person, each and everybody has two dimensions. One is a socio-national dimension. Second is socio-personal dimension. Whenever a person has a socio-personal dimension, his wife and children, his domestic rights and liabilities, they come forward. No doubt, we have to execute that. But the socio-national dimension has equal emergency that these things are to be executed. Number one, even though we are not directly concerned, each and every impact that is there due to the imbalance of national, social, economical security measures, they affect us, affect our business, affect our livelihood, may affect our lives also, because it is not sure. It will certainly affect our future generations. So we should also use our socio-national dimension. And yesterday I told that expecting a nation to do is so idiotic. It is the duty of any person to integrate within himself and also with others. They should awaken, they should admonish, they should protest against the ruling party, and they should see that somebody, rules should obey the rules, or somebody, those who are ruling, they should obey the rules, or somebody, those who are going to obey the rules, are persons to be selected for ruling. Either we should see that the rulers obey the rules, or we should see that the obeyers of the rule are made as rulers. That is our democratic integral right that we have to make. And coming into Adhyayana, whenever you see a problem, it is known as analytical study. You must understand the ontological situation, you must understand the teleology, the purpose of any act, the base of any act, the multidimensional issues of any act. So you must know the source, origination, various other dimensional studies, contemporary study, futuristic study, what is the infrastructure and the power available with us, and what are the things to be done, what are the things that are lacking, how to procure them. These things are systematic, analytical.